welcome to Sellersville Middle School. My name is Sean Kent. I'm the principal of Sellersville Middle School, and it's my privilege to welcome you to the African American Heritage Dinner. This is the fourth annual for the Sellersville community, and it is the capstone event for our month-long African American history and culture celebration at both schools. I say the capstone event because this is the part where we really get to have the students, the community, and the staff all together for our celebration. So welcome, and I hope you enjoy your evening. A lot has gone into this evening. We have had people planning this event for about 3 or 4 months at this point, from community members to students to staff at both of the schools, and I'm sure that you are going to enjoy yourself this evening. I'd like to introduce now the principal of Sellersville Elementary School, Kim Seidel, with another welcome.
Good evening. I'm Kim Seidel, and I'm going to bring greetings from Sellersville Elementary School. I'm excited to be a part of this evening. I know this is my first time, and I'm looking forward to all of the fun. I also would like to thank the PTAs and the students and all who have helped make tonight a huge success. I know we're going to really be in for a real treat tonight, so again, thank you. And I'm going to turn it over now to Ms. DiMaggio, the Sellersville Middle School PTA president, to bring on some greetings. So have a great time. Thank you.
Good evening. We'd like to welcome you. Mr. Daniels and I were just kind of kidding when said been playing 3 or 4 months. We've been playing it since the last meal. You all know how that goes. We'd like to welcome everyone. We've got some really good things going on tonight. We have our local kids that are going to be dancing and singing, and we have a dance troupe out of Delaware, Doak, Delaware, Sankufa. They are a drum and dancers, and we had them here last year at our school, and you're in for a really big treat, you really are. And of course, as you can see, we have our jazz band from SMS sitting down here. And so just everyone, just relax, have a good time. That's what we're all here for tonight. We're here to celebrate Black History Month, which is what we've been trying to do all month. And this is just like, kind of like bringing it to an end. So thank you.
And I like to talk with my hands, so I put the mic in. Good evening to everyone. And truly, I do thank you all for coming out and helping us to celebrate us. I look at the yellow tablecloths and the black tablecloths, but I also look at the variety and the multitude of the color that is in the room. As we were planning and we talked about what color should the tablecloths be, I said all the color that's going to be in that room, yellow, will be just fine. You know, so I thank God today that each of you are here. I thank both our principals for allowing us to have this day, and I thank our children who were so willingly able and wanting to come and help us this year, that will be serving you on the other side when you go for your food. So as we prepare, we just ask that you would enjoy the opportunity to come together, that you will, when you leave this place, that you'll be able to go and tell someone that not just that you came here and you had something to eat and that you were entertained, but also that you learned something about yourself, your culture, or your history, all right? So at this time, I just want to say, if there are any parents here from Sellersville Elementary School, or any parents here from Sellersville Middle School, we will have a demonstration of First in Math, which is a math program that your kids are learning this year in the media. And you could go there for the demonstration. It'll only take about 10 minutes. You'll receive a ticket to enter into the raffle for going to the demonstration. Ms. Baldwin will be waiting there at this time, like right now. You could go for that demonstration. And she'll show you what they're learning and how they can even use that on their spare time instead of some of the games that they play to prepare. At this time, led by Mr. and Mrs. Leventhal, we will have the Eagle Squad from Sellersville Elementary School.
Right.
For Mr. Demby and our jazz band. Let's give him another hand. On February the 23rd, 1868, this young man was born. That's the day my father was born. Not that year, but that day. August the 27th, 1963 is when he passed away. And that man was W.E.B. Du Bois. And he was a writer, a historian, a leader, and one of the founders of the NAACP. He was born in Great Barrington, Massachusetts, and was a gifted student who became a reporter for the New York Globe when he was only 15 years old. He later attended Fisk University and then transferred to Harvard University. He was the first black to receive a PhD from Harvard University. He also became a teacher and later studied the state of black people in the USA and around the world, and wrote many books. At this time, I want to introduce you to Ms. Chanel. Chanel Copper, and I are parent coordinators. I am a parent coordinator here at Sellersville Middle School, and she's a parent coordinator at Sellersville Elementary School. And our job, as long as when I'm a person, is to help our parents and our students to be together in education, to do whatever we can to allow and help parents to have a voice in education. So this is Ms. Chanel.
Hello, darling.
I also want to remind you, along with that presentation that should have started already, there is art in the hallway. There's a solid auction, and this art was made by our very own students here at Sellersville Middle School. You can go out and place a bid on that art to purchase it. All the proceeds will go to the art department. There's also a lady from the health department out there with a wheel, give you some health facts. We just ask you to spend some time and see them and learn some things and get some things from them. Also, there is a photo booth out there. You can go out there and get you all dressed up and get your picture taken, all right? We also have character counts out there. Ms. Elaine Butler is here to share some information. And I just want to encourage you while she's here. We're looking for volunteers. We're looking for mentors, you know, to go into school and help our kids who need someone to help them a little bit, to mentor them. It doesn't take you 20 hours a week, not even 20 hours a month. Maybe 2 or 3 hours. It's something that, you know, we just want to be able to help our kids in any way we can. So Ms. Elaine Butler's out there also from Character Counts. There's also a raffle that's going to be taking place, some baskets in the hall. So if you haven't had a chance, you can purchase your ticket. That raffle will go off late towards the end of the evening. But make sure you get your ticket. There's some nice baskets, some movie baskets, some nice things for men in one basket, and some wonderful things for ladies in another basket. At this time, we're going to ask the jazz band for another selection.
Thank you.
Come on, we can do better than that. Let's give them another hand. I know you're eating, but let's give them another hand. Does anyone know who created the first traffic light? First traffic light. You know? Garrett Morgan was an African-American inventor and a businessman, and he was the first person to patent a traffic signal, and he also developed the gas mask and many, many other inventions. He used the gas mask to rescue miners who were trapped underground in a mine, and soon after, Morgan was asked to produce gas masks for the whole U.S. Army. This time, we're going to ask you to prepare for the One Love, Step, and Dance team.
Thank you.
We truly thank our leaders for spending the time and working with them and teaching them the routines and just being able to give them an opportunity to build some confidence. It does a lot for a child when they have an opportunity to work together with a group. So let's give them another hand. There was a famous African-American who had a very deep and resounding voice, and it had a powerful presence. And he has acted in many, many movies, including Dr. Strangelove, Star Wars. He was a voice of Darth Vader. He has appeared often on stage and television, including the Roots 2, miniseries Roots 2, The Lion King, Sesame Street. Jones was born in Mississippi. This is James Earl Jones, born January 17, 1931. He was raised by his grandparents, as many of our children are today. His parents separated before he was born, and at the age of five, the family moved to Michigan. In high school, James Earl Jones overcame a severe speech impediment. He had a stuttering that made him almost mute for years. He was afraid to talk because of his stuttering. He studied at the University of Michigan, but left without a degree. He served in the U.S. military as a second lieutenant, and later began acting, eventually winning two Tony Awards for acting in plays, three Emmys for TV performances, a Grammy for a recording in 1977, and an Oscar nomination for movie performance. Jones now lives in New York State. James Earl Jones. Again, I want to remind you that there is a photo booth out in the hallway that you can go. You can get dressed up a little bit, put a hat on or some little costume and get your picture taken. There's also the nurses out there from the health department to give us some education on health, as well as the silent auction. There's some very nice art that's hanging on the windows of the cafeteria that you can go out and take a look at that our kids actually made, and you can bid on that art. The winner will be helping our art department. All the contributions will go towards that. We're grateful today for the many who are here, and I'm just asking if you are a retired African-American educator, if you would just raise your hand at this time. If you're a retired African-American educator, we thank you. We thank you. And we thank you for all that you've done and all you continue to do. We're thankful to have our interim assistant superintendent with us this evening, Ms. Janet Pauls. I'm looking around to see if I missed someone that I should have mentioned at this point. Okay, July the 2nd, 1908, Thurgood Marshall was born, and he was the first African-American justice of the U.S. Supreme Court. Thurgood Marshall was on the team of lawyers in the historic Supreme Court trial concerning school desegregation, Brown versus Board of Education, in 1954. As a result of this trial, the separate but equal doctrines in public education was overthrown. And after a successful career as a lawyer, the judge fighting for civil rights and women's rights, Marshall was appointed to the High Court in 1967 by President Lyndon Baines Johnson. While on the High Court, Marshall continued his fight for human rights until he retired on June 27, 1991. I know we always hear about those people who have gone on, who created history, but we have people here amongst us today who are also creating history. And we just have to always be mindful of those who are in our presence who are setting the tone and setting the path for us. Now, our acting assistant superintendent is our first African-American female assistant superintendent, setting the pace for us, ladies. Setting the pace for us, ladies and gentlemen. Before we move on, Jacob Lawrence was an African-American artist who was associated with the Harlem Renaissance art movement. Lawrence was born in Atlantic City, New Jersey, right up the road. About 13 years old, he moved to New York City, in New York, where he studied art. He soon became a successful artistically and commercially. He often painted scenes of ordinary life in vibrant colors and with startling. And in 1946, Lawrence said of his philosophy of art, "My belief is that it is most important for an artist to develop an approach and a philosophy about life. If he has developed this philosophy, he does not put paint on canvas, but he puts himself on the canvas." That means he puts all he has into his work. I do remind you also that in Queen Anne's County, branch 7024 is the branch of the NAACP. Yours truly, myself, Eric Daniels, is your president this year. We invite you to come and to see what we're about. We invite you to come and be members. Many people are not aware, NAACP is not just for black people. It can be any race to join the NAACP. Have you seen Ms. Wilder walking around? She's handing out some flyers for our upcoming Freedom Fund banquet in April. We meet on, I believe it's the third Thursday of each month, my mind's going blank, at the Graysonville Community Center. I do have applications, anyone interested in becoming a member. We would be glad to have you come out and to work with us on the calls. All right? At this time, I'm going to ask the Burke family if they were prepared to come. While they're coming, Black History Month honors the contributions of African Americans to the United States history. Did you know that Madam C.J. Walker was America's first self-made woman to become a millionaire, or that George Washington Carver was able to derive nearly 300 products from a simple peanut? This year, we had our readout day. The first Monday in every February is Black History Readout Day. And we're thankful for those who came out at Sellsville Elementary and Sellsville Middle School to read to our children. So they had an opportunity to see African American men and women come in and read to them. Not just men and women, also some couples that came. So they got a chance to see some families, people that look like them. We invite you to get on our list so that next year that you'll be able to come out and read with our children.
Put on the new. first of all, I'm trying to get myself together for after that meal. I work at a 5th and 6th grade middle school myself. We had a program this week, but we did not have any chitlins or pickles. So I'll be taking that message back to my principal this tomorrow, or Monday. We gotta do better. All right, we're the Seco for African Drummers and Dancers. We are here from Dover. We've been here, well, we came last year, we got a little mixed up in the location. We never made it. Hey, how you doing? From Dover folk in the house. And, but we're glad to be here tonight. We're going to give you about 5 or 6 traditional West African style drum and dance pieces. These young people are part of a program in the inner city cultural league in Dover as a community center. And we have the Sankofa African Drummer and Dancers, we have the Sankofa String Orchestra, we have the Sankofa Choir, and many other programs, an award-winning robotics program with these young people. They study language and so many things.
Yeah,
so we're real proud of them, and we're real excited to give you this presentation this evening. We were waiting on, this is Terrence. Here's Terrence, man. His outfit was a little, he had to get it together. Can you slide down one for me, Terrence? Thanks. All right, we're gonna get it started. Our first piece we're gonna do is a number called Funga. And it's a popular piece, and the words say, Funga Alafia, you say, Ashe, Ashe. So the word again is Funga Alafia, and you say, Ashe, Ashe. This is Funga.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to move on. Next piece we're going to do is a piece called Cuckoo. We'll do Cuckoo. And Cuckoo is a key Swahili word. This word means chicken. All right, this is one of our older pieces. We've been doing this piece since I was a kid in this group back in the early 90s. So this is one of our real older and traditional pieces. This is Cuckoo. Okay, so this is our last piece, this is Ibun. And Ibun is a dance that is, in this dance they give you an individual solo. And that's just kind of our welcome to you here tonight. And so this is Ibun. Thank you. Thank you. We're going to allow our dancers to come out for a quick bow. Miss Savea Brown, that's my daughter. Miss Robin Santil. Miss Fola Adamalenko. Did I say that right? Miss Kitty Adamalenko. Miss Titi Adamalenko. Miss Samaya Sanabria. And Miss Michaela Ward. And our drummers already introduced you to Terrence. Next to him, that is Keyshawn. On dudes, Mr. Zachary Brown. And our lead drummer tonight is Mr. Micaiah Brown.
Church girl up here just comes out of me, all right? Amen. We're so honored to be here to help you all celebrate this Black History event. And we know that the Black Church has been the fabric that has held the Black community together. And so it's so fitting on tonight that we will end this particular time together with a praise dance from Anchored Praise. The song title is Pour Your Love, and the artist is local out of Delaware, Miss Niecy Trott. So let's put your hands together and welcome Anchored Praise.
5. Yep.
Let's give them another hand. Truly, I thank everyone who participated tonight and even up to leading up to tonight. And all that's been said and done. I thank you, and you for coming out tonight and finding it that robbery to spend some moments with us to celebrate. Because that's what it is for me, as an opportunity to celebrate. I know it's the shortest month in the year, but that don't mean you can't keep celebrating, amen? It doesn't mean you can't keep celebrating in August and September and November and February and March and June. It doesn't mean that you have to stop. when February the 28th comes, that your learning can still go on. You can learn more about yourself and more of yourself. And I just want to remind you that on August the 4th, 1961, and what I'm saying is that the Burke family would make their way up through our last election. In 1961, the 44th President of the United States of America was born. He was first elected president on November 4th in 2008. And we all know who I'm talking about. It's Barack Obama. Letting us all know that all things are still possible through Christ Jesus who strengthens us. Amen? He was a graduate of Columbia University in 1983 and worked as a community organizer in Chicago, Illinois. He graduated from Harvard Law School in 1991, was the first African-American president of the Harvard Law Review. Michelle Robinson and Obama married in 1992. They had two daughters. He was elected to the Illinois State Senate in 1996, 98, and 2002, and he lost in 2000. Obama was elected to the U.S. Senate in 2004, a Democrat from Illinois. He has written two books, and I know there's one coming, Dreams from My Father and The Audacity of Hope. Obama won the Nobel Peace Prize in October of 2009. As the Burke family prepares to do the last election for us, I'm going to draw the winning tickets. I'm going to ask if I can get a few little young children to come and draw a ticket out for me. Let's start right here. Will you pull a ticket for me? Yeah? I'm going to see who wins these baskets. For the movie basket, ticket number 821545. 821545. For the next movie basket, Shamil, can you come pick one? Okay. 821536. 821536. You're kidding me. This is a lucky table. You gotta get over this table if you wanna win. Amen. I'm a droid this time. My cousin's threatening back here. 821564. 821564. See? See? Archie, you want to draw one for me, please? I do truly thank all the people who I worked hard again this year. This is one of them right here. Worked hard, put up with me. Just one, baby. 821552. 552. Got the men's basket. A lot of good stuff in there. And you gotta pull out a woman's name for the woman's basket. Okay? 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 All right. 821. 184. 184. He did it! For those of you who don't know, 5 months ago, I was blessed with a kidney. After waiting and sweating and praying and sweating and waiting and trusting for 7 years. 7 years on dialysis. And I always told people, it doesn't necessarily have to be in my time, but in God's time. And just briefly, I'm going to try to be as brief as possible, but it's hard not to talk about this. And I've been told that I must. 2009 was a very difficult year for me. In 2009, 1 week before my 50th birthday, I lost my mother. And of those of you who knew me, know I was a mama's boy. Still am. Yeah. But I lost my mom in February. In July, I found out my brother Raymond had cancer. And he has gone on to be with the Lord as well. In September of 2009, in fact, 9909, I started dialysis, and for 7 years, I struggled through the treatment, because it's not necessarily easy. One of the guys that was sat across from me said to me, man, the last 4 or 5 months I sat across from you, I watched you, and you were suffering. And he's right. I was suffering, but still trusting, still believing. And he said, what I couldn't believe is that for 4.5 hours you would suffer on that machine, and then it would take you 20 minutes to a half hour to get out of the building because you walking around encouraging people to keep their head up. He said, and I used to say, my God, how does he do that? And I said, my God, that's what he has for me to do. But on September 11th, at 10:30 at night, University of Maryland Hospital called me, and the lady said, this is Amy Carter from the University of Maryland. Mr. Burke, how are you? I said, you called me from the hospital. You tell me how I am. So she said, well, 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, where are you going to be? I said, the same place I've been for 7 years, at 8 o'clock on a Monday morning, in a dialysis chair. She said, well, we'll call your center if we, I will have my cell phone on me. If you have something to tell me, call me. At 7:45, she called me and said, Mr. Burke, we may have something for you. So after your treatment, we want you to go home so we'll be able to get in touch with you. Well, at 8:14, my blood pressure shot off the charts because they may have something for me. The head nurse comes over and she says, oh, no. We can't have you with
this blood pressure, we're going to take you off so you can go home. Because this is not your normal pressure. So they sent me home. At about 11:30, quarter to 12, she called and said, I got some good news and some bad news. I said, give me the bad news first. She said, you're not going to be able to eat anything for the rest of the day. I said, well, what's the good news? She said, come get your kidney. So, oddly enough, my first call was to whom we called 411. I called Bunny first because I knew in calling Bunny, everybody else would go. And then I called my wife and told her we were going to Baltimore. I texted my son. He texted his little sister and told her, I'm coming to get you. You're getting out of school. Then he texted my oldest daughter and said, come home. We're taking Dad to Baltimore. My oldest daughter, being a lot like her father, her boss told her, you don't have any more time off. And if you leave here, there's going to be some trouble. She said, mister, my dad is getting a kidney. And if I stay here, there's going to be some trouble. So off we went to Baltimore, and before I left, I just posted a simple statement on Facebook, going to get my kidney. Praise him. And here I am. Here I am today. And I'm just telling you this story before Bunny tells you this story, because she sometimes doesn't let me tell this story before she tells it. Now, that being said, I'm not going to hold you all up anymore. I'm going to do a little bit of John the Revelator and send you home.
John the Revelator. 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 John the Revelator.
in your program, you should have had a little piece of paper there. I sure hope you filled it out. If you'd like to help us next year or be part of our committee, we surely do need more hands, and we need more brains, we need more help. We need you to help us to continue this program and to make it even more beneficial for our children. Again, we thank you for coming. We thank everyone who participated and all of those of you who came out. God bless you, and thanks be to all.